Hello, it's me again. Okay, first of all, I'm gonna open this box, and then we can finish the varnish on Mr. Timothy. I got some new brushes that a friend of mine told me I should try. I don't know how exactly she applies her varnish, but we'll try tapping it off with the brushes and see if it helps make any texture. I still haven't gotten my box from McPherson's, but it's supposed to come tomorrow because we called about it. I said it's coming tomorrow. So this one is from Bee Baby in Italy, a place I buy from a lot. Plastic's a little bit nicer this time. Let's see, who do we have? I have some paint that I need. We have, this is Jude by Olga Auer. One of those great big ones. Ooh, that's a nice, it's a nice COA. You see the little seal there? Looks like it got a little scratch on it, but mine has a little scratch on it. Yep. Apparently he's not numbered. Okay, there's all his pictures on the COA. Keep saying, hey, Jude. Okay, oh, he's got some nice detail. Look at his little fist. It's nice. I'm going to open the window just a tiny bit more. Get some more light in here. There we go. Okay. Here we go. This is the little hand. One little fist. You can see he's got a lot of little creases. And a lot of creases in his arm. I love detail. There's a lot on the back of his hand. He's got the little fat rolls on his little knuckles and some around his wrist. This is his open hand. Also very detailed. Nice nails and everything. Here's the back of his hand. It's nice. I like all these details. Look at all the details in his arm. He's got some extra vinyl here. Just pull that off. Sometimes you get little pieces of extra vinyl His vinyl's kind of firm. Not bad though. I'll have to check the head. He's got a little more of this around the flange. You just pull that right off. Just comes off. Just left over. Okay. Oh, wow. Oh, I like his feet. Look at that. He's got really cute feet. Got lots of detail on the back of his foot. Some detail on his knee and back of his leg. Little rollies. And the other foot. Yeah, I really like his feet. Those are really nice. I like it when they put detail into the feet. Looks so nice. That looks better when it's painted. All the detail on the backs of his legs. Okay, let's see his cute little face. Oh, he looks very serene. And his head is not hard. It's soft. It's firmer vinyl than some, but it's nice. Definitely not hard vinyl. I'm gonna put them all back in here. Sorry if I'm a little out of it today. I had my infusion yesterday. And I had a bad reaction. I used to always be like sleepy afterwards, but I'm like, not only am I literally slept for the past 2 days. And this morning I started falling asleep and I'm like, nope, can't do that anymore. Gotta stay awake. Gotta get some work done. I felt really weak too. I could barely get through my shower. Okay, so we have these little brushes here. Get a drink. Okay, for the second varnish, I use Americana Soft Touch, which is impossible to find right now, along with a lot of other things, a lot of the varnish. I got this stuff. It's Art Basics Soft Matte Gel. So I tried a little bit of it on a practice head, and it kind of has a little shimmer to it. I'm going to see if I can do something with it. I don't know. But I have another jar of this down here. I'm going to pour some more in here. Have it here and down on the other one. I think it's down the big one. Wheels stuck. Okay, I'm gonna pour a little bit more in here because I have too much. I think I have too much matting powder in here. I use the Reborn FX matting powder. I like to keep a little bit of the straight stuff because I think it. You can make some little dewy features if you want, just using it straight because it does. Have a little bit of a shine. Better than using like the satin varnishes and the air dry. The satin varnishes just don't really work very well. They're too shiny. So anyway, I use Reborn FX matting powder, and I just pour some of that in. I have plenty in there right now. That's why I put a little bit of extra straight Americana. But it kind of looks more brownish after you put it in there. And you can see the regular kind looks more white. I don't know if you can tell the difference. Kind of a slight color change. Not much of a difference. Okay. Mixy-mixy. This stuff's also kind of thick with the matting powder in there. You probably overdo matting powder sometimes. I'm going to scrape some of this stuff off here. That one there. I have some dried stuff around the edge. I need a paper towel. I don't have a paper towel. There it is. Usually I have a paper towel sticking out of my garbage can, but there we go. Okay. Get some more out of here. This is messy. Thinking if I can't find, I tried writing to the company. I know I've said this before. I mean, my garbage and just stuffed full. I tried to call the company or email the company to get them, ask them if they knew when it was going to be back in stock, but nobody answered me. So tried a couple times. It's so irritating when they don't answer you. It's like Come on. Can at least let people know. I mean, even if they don't know, they can tell them they're not, they don't know, you know. Not very good customer service when they don't even respond. Okay, I'm going to get a couple of brushes to, I don't want to use that one. A couple of brushes to apply and pounce off the excess. I have these new little brushes, so. Let me brush him just in case. He's got any fuzzies on. I really like the way the golden feels. Feels better than it did before when I had all the super matte in there. And it's still nice and matte, so. And it's really soft. This is how he looks with the varnish. To me, everything looks dark, but hopefully it looks better on the screen. So hopefully if I get that package tomorrow, I can do another package box opening and show you guys all the stuff that I got and the toddler that we're going to use. Got a little shiny spot right there. So that's where like the varnish mist. Sure, no fuzzies are on him. I'm just gonna brush a little bit on here. Like I said, it's kind of thicker than the I'm going to have to ask her how she applies her. Well, I think she uses a different varnish than me anyway, so I don't know. Don't know if this is going to make any texture. I did buy some texture stuff from McPherson, so I'm going to try that. A little bit of dewy stuff on his face a little bit because I like the way the kind of shininess looks on his top lip and stuff. Looks pretty cute. Eat cute. My cute little Timothy. I am learning to do like Mila, like little milk dots on the nose. I don't want them to like stand out. I want them to be really, really, really subtle. So I'm trying a few different techniques. I don't know that these brushes are going to do anything for me, make any texture. I'll try. Maybe a little. I think I can see a little bit. Then again, I don't know how she applies. I got some sponges from McPherson's too. So some of the more textured ones. So maybe if I apply with the textured sponge and then use the brush too. Maybe that'll help. I Actually, I think there is a little bit of texture. You guys probably can't see it. It just looks wet, huh? The brushes are really, really soft. I'm going in the ear with this one. Tight the ear. Okay, I'm going to do the top of the head. Now we can do his face. That's where I really want the texture, is more on the face. You know, I'm going to go ahead and do his forehead. Since this was a request, or this was told to me by a friend, I don't know if she wants me to, you know, talk about these brushes on my channel, but if you recognize this brush, then it's a makeup brush. I'll have to ask her, but I'm not going to say what brand they are. Sorry. I was thinking about just doing this off screen, because it's the first time I've used them. So she uses heats, so I think it makes more of a difference with heat set paints than with air dry. Maybe I need to put it like a little bit thicker. I'll try that on the face. I still sound kind of blah today. I'm trying to get better. I have to tell my doctor. I don't know why I had such a bad reaction. I've only been having Remicade for 10 years, you know. I know they get them from different places sometimes, I guess. So maybe that was the problem. The place that we got it from us. I don't know. Ask my doctor if he knows why I would have a worse reaction. I have like really, really low blood pressure sometimes, and when it drops down low, I get this pain in my chest and it goes up into my throat. It feels like something's squeezing me from the inside. It's like trying to choke me from the inside. And it's really scary. And that happened in the middle of my shower, and I didn't know what to do because I didn't have anybody in there with me. I managed to get out okay, but I need to go to my cardiologist. I haven't had an echo in years. I'm supposed to have an echo every like couple of years because down those effects can affect, you know, the valves in your heart, especially mitral valve. My dad had to have his mitral valve replaced a few years ago. Kind of like this. Wonder if it stays when it dries. I feel a little bit of texture, actually. Maybe I'll do another layer too. Let's see if that helps. Experimenting. Okay. So again, you guys know how to varnish the arm. If you're using just a regular, if you don't know what these brushes are, they're really soft and really close together, the bristles are, and I will ask her. It's okay to, but they're, I think they're regular makeup brushes that a lot of people use. So, that'll be it for today. Hopefully we'll get that package tomorrow. I can do a video of opening it so you can see the toddler that I'm going to use in the next tutorial. So, guys, subscribe and like if you wanna. Go out and buy some paint. Get a cheap kit. Buy some paint. Have some fun. Paint a baby. Learn how to be a reborn artist. It's not that hard. You just gotta keep working at it. Just have to have patience and perseverance. Gotta keep trying. Anyway, okay, so I'll see you guys soon. I can't talk. I forgot to tell you about Remicade Brain. That always happens. I have no brain. All gone. Brain all gone. Can't talk right. Okay. I'll talk to you guys soon. See you guys soon. Bye.